know I think mother, that, but that's...
What's your mother's maiden name?
Shihata.
And what's your current, the mail address we have for you?
It's B.O. Box 682, Anaheim, California, 92815.
So you can't receive Medicare, which of the state is not helping you pay for it?
Excuse me?
Most of the state's not helping you pay for it, correct?
Yeah, yeah. They were until, I think, July or August of 2015. And then last month, November payments, they gave me that 105 or 104, you know. And then... And then they said that the 2016 is going to be, you know, 1600. And also, not only that, but the deduction that they have me sign, it's all fraud. It's all fraud. The lawyer frauded me, the state frauded me, the doctor frauded me, everyone. And then the more I go and file complaints, the more they retaliate. And they are not only stop at there, but they commit other crime, federal crimes, by kidnapping my children. It's unbelievable. Unbelievable. And I'm sorry. Go ahead.
Well, so, let's take a look
here. Everywhere I go, they want to share cost. Everything I go, everywhere I go, the state wants just to you know, fraud us of everything. Share cost for even my in-home service. Unbelievable. Medic aid, I'm homeless and job, no car, no transportation. I don't go see my doctors. And if I don't take my medication, and I go see my doctor. I've been hospitalized many times because I get racing thoughts. I don't go to sleep for like 72 hours. And the things won't go away. And I've been, it's not even funny. Last time, last month or a month before, got hospitalized there for a week. And then the crazy place that I go there, they wanted me to say, oh, well, I'm a suicidal and I'm this and I'm drug addict and I am, in order to give me my medication. It's unbelievable. And then they want to charge me $1,055 for, and when you tell them, no, I have the, first of all, they try to deny you service and then they intimidate you and then they want you to leave a name of a family member or something for your safety. No, I'm not concerned about my safety, you know. And then they go harass them and then they bombard me with collections. It's unbelievable. And the federal government is being complacent. The federal government being complacent, and it's not like I didn't pay. It's my money, my children's money that they are trying to con us out of it. It's heinous crimes, and they're going everywhere and say, oh, well, they're refugees. I wanted to see what. That's what I want you to. Do you have an answer for me?
That you receive is too high for the state to pay for your Part B premiums. Because the state will pay for them, but you have to be making less than a certain amount, which would be... Let's take a look here.
How they figure that? There is no penal code or they just figure it out, oh, well, it's too much, let's take money. Well, how come they were giving me that?
Well,
How come they were paying? And all of a sudden stopped. Okay, go ahead.
I don't work for the state, so I can't say.
I know, but you are a social security, you are the federal government. And the state is conning us, frauding us. And that's what I'm trying to bring to your attention. Because this is what has been going on. And it's not against you. The federal government pushing us to the state. The state pushing us back to the federal government. And we are the one getting screwed in the middle. It's crime. It's not violation no more. It is frauding the people out of the livelihood and putting them in the streets. So it is who is taking responsibility? I'm calling the federal government because I am a Social Security recipient. I'm not a Californian. I'm an American citizen with disability. And there is the 1990 American with Disability Act that there are nobody is looking at it. And the state is just committing the crimes and the federal government being complacent and telling me, well, that's not, you know. Who is going to protect us from this? Go ahead.
It's not a crime they're committing. It's the...
Frauding, man. Isn't that fraud? When they tell me share cost and they want to get money that the federal government already gave it to them, isn't that crime? That's fraud. Okay, go ahead.
It will still pay for it. It's $1,333 is the most that you can make. It's still then pay for your part. The premiums, if you have over that, then they're technically they don't have to pay.
Technically, my friend, they were paying that. I'm sorry, I'm not trying to be sarcastic. I am homeless. All right? And I've been because they put me there. So, and I'm not the only one. There are thousands, millions of people that these crimes are committed by the state. And the federal government have been complacent. what do you mean? It's 13, they were paying it. And I was, you know, nothing changed. And the reason I've been homeless, and now I'm not because I got money. Before, I didn't have any income. For 6 years, I didn't have a dime in my name. And I work all my life, and I pay a lot of money in the system. And I raise my children. I pay my child support. I pay my taxes. I pay my ticket. I pay. And now they steal the you know, they get the money from the payments, all of it, the federal government, the state, and the lawyers, and the insurance company, and the doctors, and the HMOs, everyone got their greasy hand to go and take the money from my children. It's unbelievable. And they're telling me it's not a crime. No, this is crimes, my friend. When they're doing this to the masses, this is crimes, heinous crimes. Internationally, there would be a war because of this. That's what they're doing in the Middle East, and we're going there and say, oh, well, they're committing crimes against their own people. Well, why go far? Let's look at the American refugees here and all the crime, the heinous crime, financial crimes that we're committing against them. And I'm sorry, my wrath is not against you. You work in the yard like me. You probably have a family to support and everything. But this has to stop. This has to be looked at seriously. The state is frauding people out of their livelihood and putting them in the system to get the money from the federal government, and the federal government knows that. The federal government is well known. They know everything. They go on they police the whole globe. They can take care of their own people. So, but please. And I file many complaints. I file with the Department of Justice. I file with the Heart. I file with the Social Security Administration. I file. And everyone, who did what and when? Who did what and when? And if you don't answer us within 3 hours and 5 seconds and what have you, we know that you are not interested. It's unbelievable. And we continue to commit these crimes. And we don't call it crimes. It's fraud, frauding people out of their livelihood. This is crimes. When you're stealing from people livelihood that is supposed to be paid by the state and the federal government to taking care of them, we invest it, we pay. Us being here, making money for it, we have accounts for the state and the federal. So they have to take care of us. And instead of preying on us and conning us and frauding us having all these lawyers to go and intimidate people, and it's unbelievable. I don't know. Who should I turn it to? I am. Huh? Yeah, the state was paying it was paying. Look at my records. The state was paying, and there is nothing changed from back then until now. In fact, I'm getting less money because they took the overpayments. They have me sign. They force me. They will not give me my check. They wanted to take the whole check unless I sign an agreement to pay money that is they owe me. 70 whatever dollars, $79. I was getting $17.80. That's my reward. That's my, and it's not because they're giving me a gift, because I pay into the system. I work for 30 years. Okay? So now I'm making less, and then they're taking the Part B. And what happened to my Medicaid? What happened to the $250,000 that they're getting in each recipient, the state, for the HMOs, and then push them to the curb and, you know, democratically segregate them, send them to the dump, send them to the doctors that they even don't have license? I went there, my friend. Yeah, the state.
Yeah, it looks like they should pay.
Yes, they should. That they. Go ahead. I'm sorry. They were paying it. Not only that, but they are. You know. They deny me every social, medic. You know, if I don't sign with the HMOs. They wanted me to pay co-payments to the doctors, and they don't like people to say, I am a Social Security recipient, I am an American, and they know. If you don't, you know, it's unbelievable. If they don't get the money in your name, the counties, they keep fighting, and every county pushing everyone, and they take you, oh, well, you are here, you want to do that test, you want to do this, and you want to, oh, yeah, it will get you to, it's unbelievable. Everybody is pushing the other person to fraud people out of their livelihood and take the money in our names. And the federal government being complacent. Being complacent. And they, God forbid if you tell them that. They look at you like they want to... I'm sorry, but... They declare war against you and your children and your dog, everything. Because you stood up and you said you guys are committing fraud. It's unbelievable. And I wanted someone to explain to me what you call that, if it's not fraud.
Well, just like I said, just based off the numbers, they won't pay for the Part B premiums because you can't make over the $1,333. And they did pay it for 1 month, but it looks like, you know, they had their... Why are they picking up for the 1 month? I don't know. I don't work for the state of California, but...
No. They give me this month, November, they pay it back. They give me $100, $104.95. I got two checks. I got... Yeah. Yes. Oh yeah, then they start look. They started deducting again. No, I think August payment. They took three payments back, so I got only what $1,300 or whatever. They took three payments because they were paying, and they took all of this, and then they started taking it. But last month, November, they give me that money back. They give me the Part B, and then. I got a letter here. That's why I'm calling you guys. It says that, you know, in 2016, your award is not going to go up or down. and it's 1780, and then the Medicare Part B is going to take a 105 or whatever. Your final payments is 1600. After that, 70 whatever for the extra payments or overpayments that they have done, which is I still disputed. But no one, they told me that you gotta have a hearing and everything. And every time I go to Social Security Administration, they jerk you around. The person that working for the state, they sit there and write stuff without your consent. They keep typing and typing and typing and typing and take and making false statements that you did this and you did that. And they don't let you, they don't give you a copy of what they are doing in your Social Security to the federal government. Fraud. Without consent, they go there and add in your account and write and take and do and everything. The state is frauding people. And that there is no, and if you tell them, I try to film myself for my own records, which I am entitled to. Okay?
Well, they, you better pay them, the Medicare.
Excuse me?
For that 1 month.
Huh?
We said the Medicare you've been paying for except for that 1 month.
Yes, that's very true. But they were paying it. And then in August, I think, they went there and they charged me back for all the time that... No, because I started getting my Social Security last June. June of 2014. And from there, they were taking these payments. They were only giving me 13 some, I don't know what. And then they adjusted. And then they, you know, the Obamacare. And then they start paying it. And he said, well, because you are not doing this. And I was homeless. I'm still am. Not because I choose to, because the state themselves, the counties, the HUD, is the one that pushing me out because I'm filing complaints with the federal government. They don't like me. Because I stand up and I said, you're doing this to everyone, not only Muhammad Shaban. Okay, I'm a non-profit. I start a non-profit myself and I pay for it from my own Social Security. Every penny is going there, going to my non-profit, helping people that they've been victimized by the state and the federal government in the streets. Children. Single mom with children and everything else. It's unbelievable. And now, and I keep calling the Social Security Administration, tell me that's a state problem. The state tell me, no, that's a Social Security problem. No, that's a county. No, no, no. And I am getting dizzy. I'm getting dizzy. And I know my rights. I thought I do. And no, and the federal government is not answering me. The Department of Justice, I find many complaints with them and not saying anything. And instead, they counter and they said that I was a terrorist and he harassed me, kidnapped my children, did everything because my name and religion and what I stand for. That's it. And now they wanted me to be just bent, excuse my name, but they wanted me to be grateful that they are doing that to me and my children and my ex and everyone else. It's unbelievable. That's our money. This is our money, and the state is preying on us and taking the big bucks in our name and give it to the HMOs because they are corrupted. That's what is going on. Corporate America owns the whole globe. So I wanted to know what's going on. Is it, you know, is the Social Security Administration knows about that? Now, I'm sorry, I'm not upset with you. Now, let me to move to another subject. I have two grandchildren, and they don't have, their moms are single mom, and I wanted to adopt them, so they can, I can take care of my grandchildren. How to go about that, sir?
You want to adopt your grandchildren?
Yes, sir. The father is not anywhere to be found, and I wanted to adopt, I want to raise them. Well, I'm not going to raise them physically, but I wanted to participate and give them my Social Security.
Well, once you adopt them legally and you let us know, then they can be eligible for some of your Social Security.
Excuse me?
So if once you adopt them legally, then they could be eligible for all of your grandchildren.
Once I adopted them, what? My grandchildren, whether I adopted them or not, my grandchildren should be legible, right? Especially.
No, not if you don't. Only if you adopt them.
Adopt them, okay. So how to go about that?
That's something that the state handles. You got to go through the courts in the state.
Okay.
The Social Security handles. We don't do adoptions. That's a court thing. So you have to get it. You know, go to file a petition in your family court.
Okay. Alrighty. And then once they are become legally adopted by the state courts, then they are entitled. Okay, thank you. That's all I wanted to know about that. Now the other subject, I guess it's out of your jurisdiction, right?
Correct.
So I have to contact the state or?
Yeah, it's the state, because they're the ones that pays the Part B premium if you're eligible. If they say you're not eligible, then that's what it is. But that's not something that we can override.
Okay, but the federal government knows though that the states are doing that. Okay, well, thanks very much for your time, and I'm sorry if I was loud and obnoxious. It's not that.
You're fine.
Thank you, sir.
Have a nice day.
You too. Bye bye now.